welcome to this video. Today we are doing Losing My Religion by R.E.M. Obviously, I hope you recognize the song. It's a lovely tune, a very, very interesting guitar part. Simple parts, but very effective. He uses a mandolin to play some of the stuff, so I just rearrange it so that we can play it on the guitar. Okay, so let's have a look at the intro. It's playing something like this. I am basically rearranging the whole thing for just one guitar, as I said. Because the guitar is probably playing just the normal chords and the mandolin is playing this melody. And that is happening as a pickup line on the third beat. So we will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Which is basically an A sus 4. And I'm playing the full chord until the second string on 3, 3. And I play on the first string, open, so it's 3 and 4, and I play the same thing, and then I go to F major 7. I don't know if you noticed, but I play a bit with the pinky, where I play basically at the 3rd fret of the 2nd string. And as you can, as you will hear, this is a recurring riff in the intro, and you will see later. Now we go on the 3 of the 2nd bar. We go on G6 9, because he's playing the E string open, and that finger, the 1st finger, goes on the 2nd fret of the 3rd string, and we play again the same riff. As the pickup line, we will play, and then we go on the 3rd string. So it's just slightly different. So 3 and 4, and then we go to A minor. And here we play the same riff as the F major 7. With the pinky, we just touch press there on the 3rd fret of the 2nd string, and then we start all over again from the pickup line again on 3 and 4 and 1, and then we go to A minor, and then G is played on the end of 4, so it's anticipated. Then we go to the verse. Now the verse is A minor. Where we play this little trick over there, which is basically A minor, lifting that finger, we get A sus 2. So. Instead of going like this, I just lift the 2nd and the 3rd finger up, just to make my life a little bit easier. And now this section here repeats 3 times. I don't know if you noticed, but D minor and G, they've got a different rhythm than the rest of the verse. As as you can hear, it's on purpose, because now it's driving a little bit more towards the chorus itself. So just pay attention to that when you play it. And now we've got the chorus. Now the chorus, we play F is the first chord. You can play the full bar chord, or you can just play this mini version of the F. They're both fine. This F has got a little bit more. It's a little bit fuller, because obviously we are playing more strings. But they're both fine. So that's on the first bar. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then it's D on the end of 4, so anticipated. And then G is also anticipated on the 3. So it's 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 3. So this is quite cool. So these are the first two bars. Then the next two bars are A minor. 1, 2. On 3 is G over B, which I actually play just like that. So I press the 5th string on the 2nd fret with the 2nd finger, and I play only the 4 inner strings, so I leave the 2 E's out. And then I go to this to C on 1, and then on 3 I play C like that, so I take that finger out, and then I play C again on 4. So it's C. Now the reason why I do that is because the actual bass player in the original record is playing the bass like this: A minor, G over B, C, D, E, and I want to try and give that kind of a feel as well when I play by myself. So I just do A minor, G, C, D, D. Can you hear the melody? It's just kind of cool, you know? Just to make it a little bit more interesting. Then I go back to F, D minor, and G, just like the first two bars of the song. On the end of 4 is also anticipated, and this is the chorus. Now the way the song goes, it basically goes back to the verse, then back to the chorus, and then it goes into the bridge, which we play. The chords are G. We just play the chords, we let them ring, all notes basically. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, then F. 1, 2, 3, 4, G again. 2, 3, 4, then C. What's just a dream? 3, 4, C. 1, 2, 3, then G, and then it goes back into the verse.